Seems like a long time, but nothing seems like a long time when I am with you. I feel like I'm walking on water since the day that I asked your father to let go of his daughter. So give me your blessing, sir. I'll give her all that I've got. Doesn't look like much, but it sure feels like a lot. Let her take my heart and take my hand. Take my heart and take my hand. Take my heart and take my hand again and again. Right.
give the Lord an opportunity now to speak to these two that have grown to be out and alive. Thank you for being very respectful and teaching from the church. So we are in this mass where God is going to talk to you, God is going to talk to us, but the merits of something simple, very powerful symbol of our God and our humanity. And so we begin, remember the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us remind you of our sinfulness, O God, our Father. You are sent to heal the contract of heart, Lord, have mercy. You came to close the lips, Christ, have mercy. Yes, right in the Father, to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy. In the almighty God, have this blessed image, as you first sins, give it to each other by. Let us pray. O God, be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness uphold what you have established for the increase of the human race, so that the union you have created may be kept safe by your assistance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Please be seated and leave you.
Can remember, sir, every is the husband of a good wife. The number of his days will be doubled. A loyal wife rejoices her husband, and he will complete his years in peace. A good wife is a great blessing. She will be granted among the blessings of the man who fears the Lord. Whether rich or poor, his heart is glad, and at all times his face is cheerful. A wife's charm delights her husband, and her skills will rest on his bones. A sensible and silent wife is a gift of the Lord, and there is nothing so precious as a disciplined soul. A modest wife adds charm to charm, and no balance can weigh the value of a chaste soul. Like the sun rising in the heights of the Lord, so is the beauty of a good wife in a well-ordered home. The word of the Lord.
That she might be holy and without blemish. Even so, husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no man ever hates his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, as Christ does the church. Because we are members of his body. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This is a great mystery, and I mean in reference to church, to Christ and the church. However, let each one of you love his wife as himself, and let the wife see that she respects her husband. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth. What if salt goes flat? How can you restore its flavor? Then it is good for nothing, but to be thrown and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden. Men do not light a lamp and then put it under a bushel basket. They set it on a stand where it gives light to all in the house. Same way, your light must shine before people so that they may see the goodness in your acts and give praise to your Heavenly Father." The Gospel of the Lord. You may be seated. So these two, they choose and pick these readings. And it is like they are giving each other advice. He started. He says, "A good wife myself, his values, discipline, wada wada," as the reading said. And she answers back. She says, "A good husband must love me, must have all the qualities that are going to continue to be part of our lives. These values, as we grow together, they must grow with us. It is not a bad deal here and now. It is the beauty of God set in motion as you become a good wife on a continuous basis, going through the difficulties of life and embracing your faults. You embrace them because he, Mr. King on the other side, is ready to love you, is ready to embrace you as you are." Right at the onset, let us repeat the promise of the church that asks of us to do this for you. The church says, when you give the lessons that I am truly proud of you, that you went through them so quite faithfully. Church asks of us to continue to be with you, to walk with your family, to continue asking you, "How are you?" So I give you the privilege, after 3 months, if I haven't phoned you, to ask, "Father, where are you?" Because I have to promise this on behalf of the church. As the church says, we do not leave you on this day. We walk with you all the way. So, but as the church promises you this, it promises this because we are not doing you a favor. Today you are the ministers of this sacrament. You are the people that makes the sacrament to happen. We are here really as witnesses, as the people who formed that very important bond of what the form of marriage is. The form of marriage is, there must be two, you have the witnesses, otherwise it's not a marriage. There must be two witnesses, so law of the church. You must be there, two witnesses, and I must represent the church. That if the bishop comes here and asks, "Was the form of this marriage followed by Father Damien?" And you must define it in this way. We were there as ministers. Two witnesses signed. He was there representing the church. That is the form of what consists and makes the marriage. And the covenant now that you're going to exchange the vows is what brings God once and for all to this place to say, "Repeat again, Lord, the blessings that you gave to us when you said the story of creation. I am creating on the sixth day this beauty in the world, the crowning beauty of the world, that is human beings, us." And as God creates us and he says, "No, there's this just one final thing that I must do. You, Mr. King, must find Elize." Did I pronounce it right? I've been practicing this for the whole week. What's wrong with it? So, Wesley will harm me now. Because at that particular moment, says God says, no, look, I've done myself. But because I'm the God who loves, I can still do better. God always has got the capacity to be the best, even when you think you have reached where God is. This is why He gives you the capacity to embrace your weaknesses. And if you take your weaknesses to Him, He says, I will bring the best out of you. Because of this particular day, I created and crowned heaven and earth, that which I have created, and I pronounce it beautiful. I say, I will create marriage. He says, you, Mr. King, as your rhythm said, in the end, he read away who was the leader. He pronounced it, not me, he read it. That is why you, Wesley, must leave your parents. We spoke about this, right? Must leave your parents and form this new marriage, this new family. This is an instruction that pertains and scaffolds these commitments you're going to make, these beautiful commitments you're going to make here, are already there in the grand plan that God has for all of us, so that you may exist. You starting this after the beauty of the fresh power, you are swimming in the juice and love of the God who created us out of love. He says, I'll crown the beauty of humanity in the sacrament of marriage. So that's why you must literally leave your family and be with your wife, children. Now, I must say, since to speak to the families and to you, ladies who are beautiful, accompanying them, the two ones here, and you, gentlemen, let me start with you, gentlemen. Look, I take it that he is your friend, right? Otherwise, you will be left alone. And you look beautiful, like very morning. So, how house of monarchy you came from. So, let me say this. The best thing that you can give to him is to respect him now. He is no longer a boyfriend. He's a husband. I get to the answer. So, he's a husband. Whatever you do as gentlemen do, whatever you do as gentlemen do, it stops now. Right? Now, ladies, she is now a wife, and as such, she must be respected, given that role in the society. Why do I say this? Because what God expects now is the fact that whenever He sees you, Mr. King, what sport do you like? Whatever sport you like. If he sees you now at 9 o'clock, you're not at home. He's beginning to wonder, did Mr. King understand this commitment? And you do not want to upset God. List of all, don't want to upset him. Good luck if you do. And I'll switch my phone off. You cry. She's done whatever she has to do. All I'm saying to you is, now gentlemen, if you do have your things, go to his house, but ask for her permission. She says no, stay out. Have and do what you have to do in the confines of the household. And 6 o'clock, Amandimaka, go home. Leave them to be who they are. So must you, ladies. I beg you, ladies, please do this. If you hear stories about any of them, do not be the people who push gossip. Don't tell stories to this household. It must be perspective. It's the new circle of life. The circle of life that is formed by God. And in the gospel today, the Lord says, you are the light of the world. You are the salt of the earth. And things in this household must speak to the properties of salt, must speak to the properties of this light. That's why they're standing here on top. They're shining. We speak the blessings to you this morning, Mr. and Mrs. King, to be, because we're very proud of you. There's many people who just take each other. And some of the gentlemen say to the ladies, gentlemen, ladies, do not allow this. They say, I know. I ask one of them, why don't you marry this girl? They say, we just test drive them far. Test. Do not allow men to do that to you. I mean, they just shake. It's not a problem. It's the modern way of doing things. It is not. As long as we are created by God, there's a certain fashion and direction that the human body takes. We did not create ourselves. It's a given. We created by God, and as such, we must follow a certain pattern of life. Never mind this new democracy thing that doesn't work. You always hear people say the Constitution of South Africa is the best. I surmise it's the worst. You do everything you like in South Africa, they are not conservatives. You steal, you try to hit somebody who's coming to break into your house. The police come and arrest you. You're trying to protect yourself. Tell me what's good about that. This Constitution, I wish you the best. Now you do what you must do. I cannot do this on your behalf. Sana Pasaklif, Liso.
Dear friends, we have come together in this church so that the Lord may still strengthen your heart in the presence of the church's minister and this community. Christ, abundant blessings and love, He has already consecrated you in baptism. Now He enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage. Mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions.
My husband,
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true.
In times and in good times.
Sickness
and health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. So, to the dreams.
Can everyone see that?
Yes.
Okay. So this is a declaration of do not come close. Okay. So ladies and gentlemen, may I introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. King.
spend, receiving of this sin of the sacred bond of marriage, just as your goodness in its origin, may your providence guide its cause through Christ the Lord. Lord be with you. Lift up your hands. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. True. Just as you did our salvation, always and always be the next Lord of the Father, Almighty, and of God. For you have forged the covenant of marriage and the sweet yoke of harmony and an unbreakable bond of peace, so that the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you have accomplished the wonder of this twofold desire. Why the better children brings beauty to the world, they revive the mountains and gives decrease to the church through Christ our Lord, through him, the angels and all the saints, and receive the hymn of your praise, as without him we can pray.
Thank you.
Holy Father. Holy Father, creator of the universe, maker of man and woman in your own likeness, source of blessing for the married life, we humbly pray to you for this bride, who today is united with her husband in the bond of marriage. May your fullest blessing come upon her and her husband, so that they live together and rejoice in your gift of married life. May they be noted for their lives and the parents filled with affection. Lord, may they all praise you when they are happy and tend to you in their sorrows. May they be glad that you love them in their work and know that you are with them. Indeed, may they reach old age in the company of their friends. Come with us to the kingdom of heaven. We ask this for Christ our Lord. So for Holy Communion, the Lord was going to receive because of COVID times. Some of you must come to church tomorrow.
Pray in the grace of marriage to your servants, Mr.
whom you held, brought quickly to their wedding day, that under your protection they may always be faithful in their lives to the covenant that they have sealed in your presence. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As we sit and to now be accompanied by those two witnesses coming to sign this is the religious stuff. So if you stand where you are, wait, okay, so you have to go this way. But a lot is meant to go first. All of you are
never stop loving you until this life is over. Oh, I never stop needing you always, now and forever. See, 'cause it feels oh so right when I'm with you. It feels like I can't live without you. I just can't deny my future lies with you. Oh, oh, oh. I've had my doubts about us. Will we make it together?
Make it together.
But now I've spent time with you, I ain't seen nothing better. So whenever you
call me,
I'll come running, baby. And whenever you
me,
I'll be there in our air. 'Cause it feels oh so right when I'm with you.
It feels
like I can't live without you. I just can't deny my future lies with you. Yeah,
it feels right when I'm with you.
Oh, world, you're all I need in this world. Listen, so whenever you
call me,
I'll come running, baby. And whenever you
call me,
I'll be there in a hurry. 'Cause it feels right whenever I'm with you. It feels like I can't live without you. I just can't deny my future lies
with you,
with you, with you, with you, with you. Yeah. Whenever I'm with you, it feels right. Can't live without you. I just can't deny
my future lies with you.
Yeah.
Feels right with you.
Say it again.
Feels right when I'm with you.
You were there when I was broken. My heart is always open to you.
Feels right when I'm with you.
When I'm with you.
Always. This is Exodus DJ.
Everybody, we're gonna get the show on the road. The retinue's feet are sore now. You can see they're not even smiling anymore. They're angry with y'all because y'all drinking and they're not drinking. So, DJ, let's get them inside. You're allowed to put your name, and please clap your hands or something. Let them come in with a beat. Hey, Willow, you eat a lot now. We lucky I'm married. But you know, we live in South Africa, right? Husbands can have only wife. But the new law states that a wife can have only husbands? I'm just up the road, Elise. Anyway, my wife is here. Alicia, single today, yeah? She understands, man.
Who said I'm dead?
No. I was saying, she is looking quite beautiful today.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'm a queen!
Aibo! Queenie! Aibo! Yeah, let's, I know you're all hungry and all, but we have to wait because the food's not ready yet. Let's get the formalities on the road. We're gonna do speeches.
I wish you all the best.
Don't cry.
Are you properly true? Anyway, welcome to the family. Yes. I wish you all the best. Congratulations.
Well done, Mr. King. Takes a lot of courage to come up here. Oh, looking at all your faces, hey, I won't even say four words. You got to bet you something. But nevertheless, the show must go on. Mr. Green. Where's Mr. Green? I can't see him. As I was saying, about Nabola and all that, Wesley, Did you pay your labola? You paid your labola?
No, just I paid it.
Oh, how many cows you gave him?
13 cows for one cow.
You know, we're going to slaughter that cow tomorrow.
That's it, yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Everyone's invited to Olive Grove.
47.
On Maria Crescent.
No, 47 Olive Grove.
You know what I love about South Africa? Hey, the other day I'm driving behind this car, right? You know, you always get these vans in South Africa. The van is full and our kids are going to work, right? And then these also staring at you, driving behind them. And they're like staring at you. Some of them is like, eh. And now you got your wife or your daughter in there. You angry on the try to overtake these hoes, yeah? Where you can't go nowhere. These hoes are looking at your fro or your daughter or whatever. You know what I do to them? I trigger the situation. Soon as I'm looking at them, I start licking my lips. Those hoes check my mom. What happened here? I don't want to, I stop and no fuse. They start telling you, come. Check it in, no, this one is serious. Then when you drive up next to them, you go, sweetheart. You make them more angry. So don't be afraid to drive behind those guys. I understand most of you are saying, hey, you're like, overtake quickly now, relax. Treat them with kindness. Anyway, next up, we're gonna have oh yeah, okay. From Elise's side, we're gonna have Auntie Odie. Auntie Odie here. Oh, there she coming up. Let's give her a round of applause. No dance, Auntie Odie.
Good afternoon, everybody. Elise and Willow are beautiful, absolutely beautiful. I pray that this day, this beauty, this love that you're showing us is going to be for the rest of your lives. And I will be there, as Pastor said this morning, we are here as witnesses to support you. And I want you to know that whatever you're going through, you can always come to me. No matter what it is, we will sit and we'll do what the Bible says, we'll reason together. I was actually asked to come and speak on behalf of Elise. But I was given strict instructions. She said, Auntie O, I don't want you to say anything bad. I want you to come and speak spiritually. So I don't know if she needs it or one of you all need it. I sat in the church this morning and everything that I wanted to say to the two of you, because I'm not yet to speak to one of them, I'm only here to speak to the two of you all. The priest had actually brought it up. And I sat in a plan and I said, Lord, what message would you like me to still give them that maybe hasn't been brought to the surface? And I thought of Corinthians. Corinthians 13 speaks about love. And I know I was married for 12 years. Last year I lost my husband. And love is needs so much patience. So much patience. If you ever count it to 1,000, now you're going to have to count to 10,000 when you're married. And living as cohabitating is not the same as putting the ring. The ring comes with everlasting because there's no beginning and there's no end. So that is what Corinthians 13 tells us. It's about patience. It's about love. It's about being kind. Even when you want to swear that person, even when that person makes you so angry, you need to count to that 10,000. It's not, love is not about being jealous or being proud or being bitter. In Genesis 1, it tells us that we are, you two are one. And if Elise is jealous when it comes to you, then you're going to have to be jealous as well. So the only way the two of you can grow for eternity is cut out jealousy. Okay? It's about being kind to one another. A kind word goes a long way. Elise, I'm going to speak to you as a woman, and then I'll speak to Wesley as the priest of the house. You know when Wesley's going to work in the morning, to keep that romance, because marriage is not about a wedding ring, marriage is about romance. And romance, if I have to be quite blunt, is not in the bedroom. Romance is about the little things that you're going to do for him. an hour earlier. Write him a little love note. Even if he doesn't carry a lunch box, I know he also gives them lunch sometimes. So he doesn't need you to make him lunch. Write a little note in every one of his pockets that you know he's going to find a cigarette in. And write him a little love note of appreciation. Walk him to the gate. You never know if that morning or that night will be the last time the two of you will be together. Love him, even when somebody tells you he's done something wrong. You still have to love him. Even if he does something wrong to you personally, face to face, you still have to love him. Love him enough for the true love to lead him, as the Bible says. Wesley, as the priest in the house, you need to lead. You cannot stand and look at her and say, but you are the priest. God is holding you accountable, not only for Elise, but for your two children. He is holding you accountable. If anything goes wrong, he's going to say, where were you? This union is one, but you stand accountable alone if you let her down or you let God. So today, it's all about this fantastic, beautiful thing. But tonight we're going to go to sleep, and tomorrow we're going to get up, and all this glitter and things is all going to be over. It's going to be reality. Stay as three. You, Wesley, and God. I remember when I got married 12 years ago, old lady met me in a supermarket before my husband and I were walking, but I got married at 40. Don't do the maths. We're walking in the supermarket and we came along to the vegetable fridges, and the two of us always held hands. You know, when you're old, you've got to have children, so you don't have distractions, it's just the two of you. So she came and she tapped the two of us and she said, you know, it's so nice to see two people holding hands. Not because we had no problems, not because our marriage was perfect, but because we wanted to stay close to one another. And she said, if you hold hands constantly, there's no place for a third party to come in between the two of you. Not a friend, not a parent, not a child, nobody. It will just be you two and God as this third strand. So wherever you go, constantly be holding on to one another. When you fall, Wes will be able to feel and pick you up. My husband actually lost an eye. And everybody used to say to me when we were like 8 years married, you'll still hold hands. I said, no, I have to hold his hand. Don't you notice I'm on the side of the road? Because I got to keep pushing him so that he doesn't fall into the car because he can't see on that side. So just find an excuse like I did and keep on holding on to one another.
That message wasn't even for them. I think it was for all of us up here. Newly married, old, doesn't want to get married or so. I'm sure you're token to your thoughts. Even maybe some people wrote it down. I see your chats and you're going to be writing quick and fast. Like, hey, I'm so slow. I think he's going to get it. Thank you, Saudi. Another round of applause from Saudi. Thank you. That was a very nice speech. Eh? Even I took some words there. I'm gonna write notes to my wife too when she goes to work. I'm sorry, love, I will write your notes. No, I don't write notes. I'll type you one. Okay, we continue. Wesley wants me to call up one of his Esmond's, Bryson. Bryson is going to do some speech on behalf of you, please. Come, Bryson, let's give him a round of applause.
Are you there? Say, yeah, baby.
Yeah, baby.
No, it's not all right. Yeah, but I can't say much. I was always just telling me what to tell you. I don't have much to say, but honestly, my thing is they need to be thanking me because I've been in a hot sun in and out of town, China Mall, Chinatown, Japan, all those places, yeah? Pastries, yeah? Yeah, Pepsi, all the shops under the sun. But I didn't mind at all because I won't tell all these people about, you know, how I became the best man. But it means a lot to me. And you see the happiness on your face, right? I never had that. Yeah, I pulled my face when I was married. My wife had to know that I was serious about marriage. She checked. But once you start smiling, she checked, ah, no, I've got this in here. So I said, all right. But I pulled mask for 5 years only. 5 years. Yeah, so my thing is, you all as well, you understand. With all 10 children that you have. So basically, the son. And you see that look on Elise's face. Remember when I told you of that? Even Chase threatened you, he said you're gonna die if you keep on pressurizing your throat. You understand? The thing is, bro, I'm not, I don't know what to say. I'm not a person that can give you an advice. You understand? You see, like, we can go, not carry advice and everything, you understand? But the thing is, when you see a couple that love each other, you understand? That's what I see in your life. And they don't see that every day. You get me? And when your wife tells you off and you fight with them, you think, ha, I wish I had that. But I too get told of, ah, it's in a while, every second hour. But, bro, love you all the time.
Thank you very much, guys. Let's give him another round of applause. You weren't supposed to do a speech, but hey, Wesley, check, I had so let me get some words out, just quiet, so. But nevertheless, yeah, Bryson, I did a great name. I'm 17 years married, eh? Come on, clap at least. Come on, I'm 17 years married, and I did give him some advice. I told him, stop standing on the road. At least stand in the yard.
How old are you?
Hey, Papa. You want to, hey, I want you, yeah. Take you out, jump out. But nevertheless, my advice, Wesley and Elise, you know, whenever there's something wrong and you see you're fighting and all that, don't do it in front of everybody. Like how you invited everybody here today. You got a problem? Close the door. Sort your problem out in the room. And come on as a happy couple. Yes. Show these people that you're no more fighting and you're happy. And you're winners. Because winners know when to? Who's gambling, yeah? Can see the punches, they're all on one side. Okay, we're gonna call up Elise's cousin. Elise's cousin, Mishi. She's gonna say something on behalf of... Are you ready? You don't look ready. Mr. DJ.
Greetings to all family and friends. This was actually a last minute thing. I'm not one to speak in front of a crowd, but I have wrote another poem. Elise and Lizzie, first of all, I want to say you guys are looking very, very stunning, absolutely. And I want to wish you guys all the best. May the two of you stay in everlasting love, and may your love bring forth a beautiful offspring to bring you joy through the years. And may you find pure happiness and perfect peace with each other. Once again, congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. King. Much love.
Thank you, Michelle. Another round of applause for her. She looked like we went on Google quick and fast. But that was a nice speech. Do you want them to have more children? Three is enough, man. What kind? Oh, and I'm telling you, stop at 3 hours. I'm joking. I'm divided to 5 now. 6. 7. Oh, fire. Zabalazo. This man will overtake you, Mamu. God, what's 9? He said. Yo. You have a technical view. Mkunzi. You know what Mkunzi means?
Oh, some of you know.
Believe me, he knows what it means. Okay, next we're gonna call up Mr. King himself. Wesley, are you ready for your big speech? She can pick up the phone, Wesley, I need ice. He's like, make ice, there is ice in the freezer. But he still comes with the bag in the house. Am I right, so? Yeah, I think we've come to, not the end of all the speeches, but I know there's a lot of you already married, I can see. Does anybody want to, on behalf of you all, I'm not forcing you, I'm not going to pull your hair out and all these things. Do you want to say something from the bottom of your heart? Just pick up your hand slightly and I'll come to you. You don't need to ask. Willie! Willie! Hey, sister, Willie is happy. Okay, Willie, thank you very much.
Good evening, everybody. Our family is not a
people have many words. But I just want to say, Mila, brother, well done. Melis, you're looking beautiful. Mila, you're looking handsome. Congratulations to the both of you. And Elise, my sister-in-law, welcome to the family. Thanks.
Thanks a lot, Mila. Oh, who's standing up now?
You're
standing, need you on the talk. Thank you, Molly, once again. Give her a round of applause. Thank you very much, people. I can see a lot of hungry faces here. You're looking at me bad, like I'm holding your lap. I'm not holding your lap. The people want to talk. And I got one special person out to say something today. And she wrote a big speech for you. I went and lost one because I saw a speech outside. Woo! I don't know if it's from the gal or what do you want a gal? Lipstick! Here's the one, lipstick! Yes, I'm going.
Son for taking responsibility of his family and to keep that love flowing in the family. We also want to welcome Elize Green, now Mrs. Kim, to our family. We're not perfect, as every family got their flaws, but I'm sure they can make it work for them, as long as they make God the center of their marriage. Congratulations.
Yes, another round of applause for the person that brought this stuff into the world. Thank you very much. Oh. Now, Luca is looking at me. Hey, mommy, I don't know if you can talk like that. I got another request from the bride and groom. Wesley's favorite cousin, Shayna, will say something on behalf of the family. Let's bring her up here, ladies and gentlemen.
A long way from teenage days, so I'm sure we all know Wesley and Elise's love. It's good to be here. Congratulations, guys. Wesley, you got your wedding. You got everybody that you wanted there. So I think we're going to have a lovely evening. We've got God here too. So I just want to say congratulations, Elise. Standing. We got our sparkle. We got everything we needed. So congratulations, guys. I'm proud of you. Welcome to the Mary Club. It's going to be a beautiful journey because you've got all of us with you. Thanks, guys.
T-shirts, fine. Shame, will someone give us some t-shirts on here? By the way, I hope you'll all know where you are today. And because I was outside there in a smoke bay with somebody there. And this old chewy. Hey, what time the funeral starts here? I told him, no, the body's arriving at 3 o'clock. I don't know what this old smoking is. Hey, poison. If the body comes now, hey, this old gonna start singing, bro. But anyway, you'll know you're that. Mr. and Mrs. King's wedding. I'll give this up to you. It's their day today. I don't want no one coming and spoiling this day, because me, I'm a bouncer myself. You can see my size. I'm more things than me. I choke slam you. So anybody gonna be violent? We got a rhino photographer, also a bouncer too, yeah? We're gonna hold it out and put your outside and don't come back in here. Let's have fun today, people. Today's a day of celebrating the wedding of Mr. and Mrs. King. Just some formalities for the day. As you can see, the toilets are there in the back. Don't go and pee now in the in the car park, because the security is there at the end. And this camera's watching you, and I don't know what the answer is looking at the screen. Hey, look at that fella there. What happened to him? So please. There's a toilet there. And we are observing all protocols today, so mask up, social distance. Even your dancing social distance, I mean, like, you know, like all of the same dance, please, for the slow jams. Look at the bride, they're like, ooh, I'm gonna hold my man close up, and hold it. Not holding close today. Alright, and we're gonna go ahead and cut the cake now. Now. Hey, she's looking like you. You want to do it now? No, I'm joking. We're gonna have. And now, understand you're all hungry. Let's say something, bro. Come, Sean. They want you to say something at least, bro. Let's put it up for Sean. No, he's so sweet.
That's awesome. Good evening, everybody. I'm the host, Kaz, I'm sure. I just want to say congratulations, Kaz. Pull the work down. Hit it to the marker. That is this looking beautiful. Well done now. Anyway, what else can I say? I just want to say I'm proud of you all. You pull the work, you know what I'm saying? We started together, but 12, 11 years together. Remember? Fucking a top of the band along, pull over the shoulder, I don't care. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's good, we release it not. But, well done, Nixia. I'm very, very proud of you, and you paved the way, and we need to put this thing together. And everyone have a beautiful evening, and just remember I'm around. You know what I mean?
Thanks a lot, Sean. Thank you very much. Anybody from the Green family want to say something? Mark, right? I'm standing by Elize. Why don't you pick up your Zen or something, please?
Good afternoon to everyone. My name is Timothy. I'm Elise's uncle, father, and I are brothers. Just want to say thank you, Willem, for accepting Elise. I know you promised a long time, but at least now, Mr. King, you got yourself a queen. Thank you.
Zainia.
Just joking.
So fish, that's what we like. I said we've got a lot of different provinces in here. You said you learned not in the house?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't want so much in this. When's not in the house?
Yeah.
In my house, I said you're both yes.
But yes.
Anyone from Surname here?
Yes.
That was anyone from Merrisburg? They took a long journey. Coxton? Gauten?
Tata.
Tata. I'll give it up on Tata at least. Anyway, I thank you all for making a long journey from where we are coming from. But out there from Windsor, please. Security! Hey, things are hot from Windsor. Such different. You're nice and smooth. The gold ones is going missing a lot in the weddings, and I'm watching you. Okay, we love to all be blessing the food. Eh? Thank you very much.
Gracious Heavenly Father, once again, we are a privilege to have you a part of our midst. Your word says we two or three are gathered, Lord, you are there as well. So we thank you for being present at this gathering. We ask you, Lord, that you may bless the food that has been prepared for us. Help us, Lord, to be nourishing to our bodies and help us to be fit for your service. We ask you to bless the couple before us, Lord, guide and protect them, and help us also to be strong to be able to protect them as well. Be with us, forgive us when we have failed you. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Amen. Thank you, Ansaudi. Thank you very much. Did you bless something?
Thank you.
car, you can have water, mineral, juice, that's fine. I apologize if there's only alcohol. I will try to put the location for non-alcoholics.
Some of the princess, please send us. Thank you.
As all our glasses fully ready. Hello. As our glasses fully ready.
Hold on.
I can't hear you. Okay, now wait.
Here the toast. I'd like to just say, share one thing. Elize came to my life at the age of 8 as a social worker. I saw Elize from Ugly Duckling turn into a swan. Today she's a swan. And I thank every single person in this room for making her the swan she is today. And so with that, let's all raise our glasses for making Elize and her husband the swan she is today. Cheers to everyone, to the kings. Cheers to the kings.
The DJ wants to dive. And he's coming to dive in soon.
Wait. The DJ wants you to dive first. So we come to diving suit.
Who wants him blindfolded? Blindfolded. Hey, Willow, can I go play?
Hey. Yeah, I'm giving him a, this one here, a tablecloth.
I'm gonna go get some more.
surprisingly, the bride and sister nominated themselves. They were also, they want to lead this wedding.
Join the wedding
and let our passions run wild.
Angie.